Welcome back and thank you for watching this video. My name is Olaf van Linden, top expert in procurement and supply chain. In today's video, part 8, category strategy, you will see and understand in a unique way, thanks to the support of the youngest consultant, Vincent, the concept and visualization of understanding, organizing and managing category strategy. This is indeed so important in order to manage your company and business in the right way, even more in the new normal. Category management is not to be confused with strategic sourcing, although category management evolved from the overall strategic sourcing approach. Category management conducts continual analysis to stay ahead of trends, risk, demand, or supply changes. Category managers also work closely with suppliers to continuously innovate, achieve better outcomes, and add value. It requires input from various parts of the company supply chain and involves many stakeholders. This is the view of a product and services portfolio bought in organization at local, regional, global, or corporate level. You should be happy if most of the pieces in this picture are sourced, bought according to the company purchasing policies, having a matching PO before the invoice comes in. This whole process needs to be in agreement, or even better, collaboration with the internal stakeholders. To start structuring, you need to know and capture what you want to know and structure. See my previous video about using data. And connecting with your finance department if these data, reports, overviews aren't available. Creating the first structure is an important and challenging process. You need to execute with the right project team, including stakeholders, management, finance, QA, QC, works council, and these last two depending on which category you are defining, etc. Also with executive sponsorship of your top management and sometimes board level. This is an important phase, creating a special view, what will be the basis, fundament of the complete category strategy approach and management of this in the end. The result will move and feel like viewing this process as Vincent is showing on this picture. Creating a category strategy is nothing more than following the process as Vincent is showing in his Lego structure process. But in real life, this takes several steps and using several models, approaches, depending on your organization's maturity, on world-class level and complexity of the total portfolio. In general, 5 to 8 steps with several sub-steps or levels, 10 to 20, to be sure structuring in the right sequence, creating the perfect category structure. Let's assume a category HR shown in red, and no worries, I just randomly selected this category and color. And you can see that after following the correct data analysis and several first steps, these are the building blocks of the HR category in a company. Following the next structure steps in a category strategy model, the main areas are shown like this. You can imagine here, recruiting, temp labor, white collar, AU in Germany, blue collar, for instance, freelancers, training, learning and development, coaching, etc., etc. And you can see that every subcategory will create a new category within the HR domain with its own categorization on basis of spend, risk, etc. Therefore, it's so important to run this process as a project team together with the business and management, and trust me, you will be surprised how value adding this will be. When doing this for all selected and created main domain categories, the overview will be like this. And let's be honest, when starting in this situation, every stakeholder, manager, CFO, CEO will be extremely happy with the overview, transparency and created strategy. This all resulting in managing the organization in a much better way and even improved competitive advantage. Even more important due to COVID, reduced risk because also better knowing and understanding the linked supply chain to the products and services in the categories and in the end products where they are used in. In the next video, part 9, I'll explain again with the help of this special youngest consultant Vincent, how to manage and execute category strategy to be sure creating sustainable and continuous value-adding results. Looking at the time again, we need to stop. Hope you've enjoyed watching this video. Looking forward to meet you soon in the next video and hope you embrace this all next to enjoy, learn and start to think. Follow me on YouTube, subscribe and stay tuned. Also, follow Allotrope GmbH on LinkedIn and connect with me on LinkedIn personally. Send in your questions. Looking forward to hearing from you.